Hey guys, how you doing? It's TDK, and I'm here doing the commentary for the first to ten. This is the first half of it, Gouken versus Rose. This is kennkou, Japanese Rose player. I've fought him quite a few times, so we kind of know each other a little bit, know a few habits. We haven't fought in a while, so I wanted to do a first to ten just to see if I've improved, because usually he kind of beats the hell out of me, but Rose does a really good job of beating Gouken pretty bad on some things. She has really good pokes, really fast pokes. She has good range on her mediums. Usually she does a lot of sweeps and kicks, but Rose is most notably known for her amazing backdash. This ultra is really a pain in my ass. I just recently found out that in that situation, as close as I was, I probably could have demon flip grabbed her. I did not know that, but I will keep that in mind for future fights and see how it goes just to test it out in my situation. I've seen really good players do it, but I don't know if I personally can do it. I'm not the greatest. So I took the first round. Right now, we're just kind of feeling each other out, seeing, you know, what we've learned. With Rose's ability to absorb fireballs, throwing fireballs just really gives her beater. This Rose, like a lot of other Roses, likes to throw. So if you're a Gouken player, or if you're any kind of player and you see Rose slide in, a lot of times they will, you know, go for the throw. Right now he's just trying to blow up crouch teching with that kick, and obviously I was crouch teching. Wasn't really sure that that first demon flip grab was going to get me in, but here we go. Nice combo. And I screw it up. That's wonderful. I was actually going for an ultra one to finish it off, and I didn't get it. But the fireball finishes her off, and it's all good. So first round in this first to 10 goes to me, and we're jumping right back into it. So this is the second game. It's one zip. And right there was what I was talking about with her throwing the fireballs back at you. With any fireball or projectile character, you have to be careful. If you kind of base your game off of that and you fight a Rose, you're really in trouble. Right there was a good example of how Rose has a really long poke, that kick. I'm not really sure if that's a fierce or a medium, but standing kick. It's got really great range, and it keeps Gouken out. And you can see she has a pretty decent jab. So she can push, you know, most of the slower characters away if you try to get in. And you have to really be careful about that. And there I go again, trying to get in to finish her off, and then she does her ultra and knocks me out. I lose the round. And unfortunately, you know, I don't fight Roses that often. That, you know, I get used to trying to, you know, go in for the kill, and then that happens, and then it's all over. That was pretty nice. Got a jab to knock her out of the soul spiral, but she got the throw. Yeah, that soul spiral has a lot of invincibility. So even though I could have gotten the crumple off of the saving attack, it, you know, she has so much invincibility off of the soul spiral, it knocked me out, got the dizzy, and I lost. Oh well, off to game three. So it's one up, and I don't know what she's trying to do. I don't know if she's looking for me to throw fireballs, but at that close of a range, it may be good to throw fireballs because she doesn't really have the time to react. If it was full screen, you have to worry about it, but close up, she may not be expecting it, but I thought, you know, why do it? Not really sure what she was going for there, but she's trying to get a focus attack. Not really sure why. Whoa, super speed. And I win. Something must have been up with the recording, but don't worry about it. Just let it roll. Let it roll. So Rose likes to do a lot of low attacks. If you know that they're coming, you can do a focus just like that, and you know, get a pretty good combo off. As Gouken, you can also do the Kongo or the parry move that he has, and keep her off of you. If you really want to play the game of, you know, keeping her out, but really and truly, Rose likes to run away, so it's really in your best interest to kind of stay somewhat close. Hoping to get a level 2, didn't get it. So now she's got me on the ropes. Oh, getting close. Too close for me. Rose is just so quick with those dashes. There we go, nice jump in. And actually, you know what? I should have finished it. I had 2 bars. I could have canceled, done the jump up in the Ultra 1 and finished it and just won the match straight up. I should have done it. And I was kicking myself after that round when I looked and I said, oh damn, I had 2 bars and I didn't do it. A little bit of poking to keep her out. That Soul Spiral. EX Soul Spiral is just so good. Blows up a lot, tons of invincibility. So now he's playing the fireball game, trying to keep me out. He's got a bit of a lead. Oh, fell short. Wish I could have got a better punish. And here's the Ultra 2, here we go. Not really too much I can do right here. I can just try to play the fireball game, keep her out until that runs out. Should have done the EX. And I missed my link. Oh. Having a bad day. And she gets another Ultra. To quote James Chin, you hate to see that kind of thing happen. Okay, so now she's up 2-1. It's not going good for our hero, old man Gouken. But we'll do it. We'll try our best to deal with this annoyingly fast dashing woman. So that was the absorption that she does. Where she doesn't do the reflection. She just absorbs it and gets meter. So as I was saying again, throwing fireballs is not really in your best interest because it'll either come back at you or she gets a bonus for it. Just, you know, I mean, if you vary your timing, you can catch her because I'm sure they have to have some kind of, you know, somewhat strict timing to do it. So and I missed my combo again. I've been having issues with my timing, and I don't know why. I don't want to say it's the lag. I mean, it could be, but it happens. I mean, some days I'm really on, and I get it every time, and some days, just for some reason, it just doesn't work. I miss it, but I love that. Went for it again. Why not? And she runs. And she ducked under the kick. I'm not sure how she did it, but I guess it lowered her hitbox and she got under the kick. Oh well. So here we go. So again, I'm still down. 2-1. Threw me out of the focus. She's doing a really good job of keeping me out. Get that combo. Hey, this would be so much easier if I actually got the combo. I mean, for some reason, you know, he's letting me jump in. He's letting me, you know, at least start that combo. A lot of really good players have, you know, no disrespect to him, but have, you know, better defense and keep me out, but he's doing a good job of poking and keeping me out, but sometimes I get those combos and boom, take a round. The one thing I've learned with fighting this particular Rose is when Rose does the soul spiral right there, you can punish it. Like, I mean, even if it's not a big punish, you can do some damage. And when you're fighting characters that like to run away and play defensively, you take every little bit of damage you can get. And sometimes trades like that are even better because, you know, Gouken does pretty good damage. That's a little bad habit of mine. Going for the focus right there. He's just throw teching like crazy. If anybody knows a good way to blow up throw techs with Gouken, please let me know, because I would really love to know it. Fireball to the face! In your face! Alright, so now it's two up. There we go. Land those combos. There we go. Right, so using the short to keep her out. And she can just throw. Like, Rose's throw is ridiculously good. And this dude loves to throw. I mean, he loves to throw. It's like he's married to throwing. And he won't cheat. Like, ever. So he's going for this meaty slide setup. So he goes for the meaty slide, and then he'll go for a throw. And while you're in block stun from the slide, he grabs you with the throw. And if you don't really know it, you're screwed. And in this round, he basically just poked me out, kept me out of my rhythm, and just kept sliding and moving around to the point of where I had to block everything, and he could do whatever he wanted. So let's try to change this around a little bit. Got a crumple. Get that combo. There you go. Goes for the throw again. Doing the pokes. Buy my time. There we go. Get in. Again, he's going for that throw. It's something I just have to keep watching out for. With Roses, you really just, you do have to be careful about those throws. And jumping up when they have Ultra 2. And that setup is ridiculous. Doing the flip grab. Regular grab. There we go. Ambiguous. I really love getting that demon flip in. That ambiguous one saved my ass. It comes in handy. If you can time it, you know, just right, your Gouken will get a lot stronger. There we go. Here we go. Show no mercy. Boom. The stun. Focus. Game over. Give me that perfect. Alright, so here we go. It's 3-2 now. Keeping it nice and tight. Keeping the games good. I mean, as much as, you know, Gouken has a bit of a disadvantage against Rose with some of the things that he can and cannot do, it's still a pretty interesting match. Going for that focus, I have no idea why. And one thing to notice is if you ever do see a Rose go for a focus like that, they're gonna backdash. Like I wanna say 8 times out of 10. I don't wanna say 9, but 8 times out of 10 they're gonna backdash. So might as well just do the palm and either blow up the focus or catch him in the backdash. If they have amazing timing, they can, you know, let it go right before you hit them with the palm, but it's worth the risk. Most times you'll probably get them. Unless they're really, really good. If, you know, they do it to you twice, then you kind of know, don't do it again. But good corner pressure. Now here I should be canceling fireballs. It's something I really do need to work on. and she catches me again where I jump up. And I knock that fireball out. Or the soul, spirit ball, whatever that thing is. And go for the slide, take the trade. And now it's 4-2. 4-2. There we go. Started off with the palm. Said, why not? What the hell? And here I started to learn, you know, instead of going directly in for the demon flip, go short, because Rose likes to slide, so go short and she'll slide right into it, go for the combo. It's one thing to kind of, you know, switch up. A lot of times Gouken players get used to going for the head and the cross up and stuff like that, but if you're fighting a character that likes to move, you know, switch it up. Nice short, knock me out. And I figured this would happen, so I just let it go, run away, and hit me with the EX fireball. Yeah, so when you're in that kind of a situation, it's really hard to, you know, one, escape, and then two, know how to get around all of that. So for some reason, I don't know why, he's just waiting. Not sure what he's waiting for, but he's waiting for something. But he loses. Snooze, you lose. A lot of times when you just stand around and wait, some people like to just wait because they expect a throw. Or they have a really quick jab and they're waiting for you to rush in, and then on reaction they just start spamming jab to knock you back, to get their offense going. So that's one thing to kind of, you know, be careful about. If you notice somebody just kind of sitting and waiting, if they're pretty aggressive and they don't have the life lead, but they're waiting, that means they're trying to wait for you to mess up. So it's kind of one thing to just watch out for. And the cross up into everybody's, you know, hated combo. That's one combo with Rose. You have to block the other way. And she does the up. So if you jump, she grabs you. If you don't jump, you have to block the other way. For some reason, I missed it. The parry, I love the parry. Why that wasn't level 3, I have no idea. Should have been. So now he's just poking me out. And it's looking bad. 4-3, I got 4, he's got 3. Don't drop that combo. And I dropped it. That would have been it. Not sure what he's doing, he's just waiting for something. Yeah, he just wanted to get that knockdown so he could set up for his ultra. And he dropped the ball. Not gonna drop it that time. Not if you just give it to me like that. Alright. I shouldn't have dropped that combo. That would have been it. This is the second game where I could have finished it if I had done my combo. Actually, the third. So again, that was what I was saying about that soul spiral. Spire, or whatever you call it. If you do crouching medium, a lot of times you can, punish him for that, even on block. She threw my throw. She threw my throw. I hate when that happens. That's like the worst thing. That's like so insulting. You threw my throw. Ooh, the dash under. Canceled into the dash under for the throw. And just waiting. Not really much I could have done. Went for it. Figure what the hell, went for it. I should have done that when she did the saving attack. But with Rose's back dash, she probably would have gotten away. Doing a little bit of zoning with the fireballs. Went for the grab, but didn't work. There we go. Get that combo. There we go. Get that damage. No idea how that demon flip grab missed, but it did. It sucks. No idea why he's going for that sweep so often, or for the grab, I mean, so often, but Rose's popes kept me out. And actually, I had a chance to win it. I had a chance to win it, but just didn't put it together in time. Alright, so now we're 4 up. This will be the last match of the first half of the 1st to 10. Hope you guys have enjoyed this exhibition so far. Still, I still have a lot to go, you know, in terms of learning with Gouken. Gouken's not. Hopefully, with 2013, he'll get the buffs. He'll get some buffs, and I don't know what they're gonna do to buff him, but you know, it'd be nice to, you know, see him move up the tier list a little bit. I mean, Gouken's a really fun character. I mean, I like everything about Gouken, character-wise. All right, round one. Just poking and, you know, chipping away at her. And seems to be, you know, a good course. No idea how I pulled that one off, but it worked. So, hey. Boom, boom. Got wise to the grab. It's just ducking out. Alright, he didn't want to lose. But he will. Alright, so thanks guys for watching. This is part one of the first to 10. So thanks for watching, and leave any questions or comments in the comments below. Thanks a lot.